Recommendations and Best Practices, GAMP 5. Often, industry groups will publish recommendations with best practices for specific activities. Here are a few examples, again with applicability to this program. International Society for Pharmaceutical Engineering, ISPE, publishes the Good Automation Manufacturing Practices, GAMP, the current, as of 2017, being GAMP 5. GAMP 5 provides pragmatic and practical industry guidance to achieve compliant computerized systems fit for intended use in an efficient and effective manner. This technical document describes a flexible risk-based approach to compliant GXP-regulated computerized systems based on scalable specification and verification. GAMP 5 has become the computer system validation bible for the pharmaceutical industry. The concepts described in the approach are quite sound and applicable to computer systems validation across the lifecycle disciplines. As the title suggests, a risk-based approach to compliant GXP computerized systems, the approach is definitely risk-based, which aligns with the current thinking by the regulatory bodies. We'll talk much more about GAMP 5 later in this program. The bottom line is that the life sciences are strictly regulated and there's a lot of help available. This program will pull the best information from the various sources to help you understand what is required for a compliant computer validation system and the best practices that are required in implementing your system. Governance. Since you're in a regulated company, you probably already recognize the importance of governance for many aspects in your work life. Validation needs governance too. Successful governance, per GAMP 5, related to validation includes establishing computerized systems compliance policies and procedures, identifying clear roles and responsibilities, training. We should point out that this should really be competence, since training is only one way this can be done. Managing supplier relationships, maintaining a system inventory, planning for compliance and validation, and continuous improvement activities. We'll cover all of these throughout this program.